did what he's supposed to do, is that, sorry. Okay, look at this point here. The co-pilot alerted the captain that no ATC clearance was given. So which is the correct thing for the first officer to do, is to remind the captain that, hey, you are not cleared for flight yet, you need to get a clearance. So the co-pilot did the right thing, but subsequently you do realize that the co-pilot did not do any more action. So for example, like the first group I mentioned, the co-pilot, the first officer, have taken a complete control of the aircraft. Which was also the case right here, because the first officer can hold the brakes or can pull back the throttle. But in this case he didn't do that. So in a way the co-pilot also have to be subjected to be saying that he is also at fault. So we cannot solely put the blame on the KRN captain.
It's clear that the policy is not good for the pilot. But why the organization still want to implement it?
Okay, for the this time duty time limit, right? Policy is actually a safeguarding policy for the company itself, because they want to ensure there are so many airplanes, so they cannot monitor every airplanes to see which location they are in now. So actually, they located this time duty limit to ensure that the pilot will actually take the responsibility and reach the destination at a given time. Because any delays when happens, right? The company will need to have made extra like penalties payments to the customer who have delayed in flight, or extra money need to be paid to the airport because they parked at an extra timing or this. That's why they implement this policy to ensure that the pilot will leave the airport and reach the destination at a given period of time, so as to safeguard themselves and of course to ensure that their service is there, that they will ensure that each flight will reach the destination at a given time.
So from what I understand, this incident is mostly caused by the complacency of the
it's like a 50-50 because that
also the contribution.
Yeah, because the captain actually like a bit complacent that, oh, I think it's right, then other people don't want to stop him, and then the whole co-pilot also, I think he didn't dare to speak out also.
Is there any way to prevent that?
Probably I think it's a personality problem. I mean, his personality problem. And as for the co-pilot, like what I say, we should always question. Just not let things go that easily.